I think the future will be much more about people's adaptability to work in many different settings. My name is Lotte Anker. I'm from Denmark. I'm a saxophone player. I play three different saxophones. I'm a composer. I occasionally teach at the Rhythmic Music Conservatory in Copenhagen. For myself as a musician, I have been studying music at the university, but I quit because that was mostly at that time classical music and a little bit jazz, not so much. So for the rest of my musical education, I've actually designed my own education with seeking out teachers which music I liked. And also when I was young, in my 20s, I was attending the same, not exactly the same, but also a type summer courses that were in Denmark, where you also were in an ensemble and played maybe a week, maybe 2 weeks. Some of them were quite long. There were a lot of interesting teachers mostly from Denmark, Europe, Scandinavia, and USA. And at those courses, I learned so much. there would be material enough and thoughts to think about for maybe half a year at least. Then I have upper structure 2-year composition education from the Rhythmic Music Conservatory also. As I said, I teach on and off. I have been a lot teaching actually the last year because of the lockdown in Copenhagen at RMC, as we call it, Rhythmic Music Conservatory. The education there has changed a lot, maybe 9 years ago or around that, into being a more artistic education, you could say. There's emphasis on nurturing and pushing the students into finding their individual voice and individual expression, which means there are many. We don't have a jazz department and a rock and a pop. They all study together, the different genres. Also, of course, a number of people working with free improvisation or electronic music. So that make a very diverse group of students, which can be, that can actually be a challenge for a teacher. But for the students, I think they meet many kinds of different genres during the different students. And it's also a school where, especially on the master's education, there are a lot of non-Danes studying, which are also from different parts in Europe, and sometimes there might be one from the US or Canada. I think there are 2 or 3 students from Canada at the moment, and there have been a few also from other countries outside West Europe. I think what we call jazz, if we're talking about jazz today, I mean, jazz in general has always been a very hybrid art form, which were, inspired by a lot of other musical genres. I can only talk for Denmark, but I'll say those times where you would rehearse and train to be a good musician, jazz musician, for instance, looking for a job in a big band. Those days are over. There are no there are not many big bands in Denmark anymore. And also being a studio musician is also, I don't think there are that many young people that are looking in those directions, at least in our country. So I think it's, in that way, I think it's nice to open it more up. And as I said before, nurture the, you know, the individual musician, not only in his or her own expression, but also getting that student to play in many diverse collaborations and ensemble types. Because I think the future will be much more about people's adaptability to work in many different settings. And most of the musicians, at least in Denmark and Scandinavia, will work as freelance musicians. So, and if you are working freelance, you have to, of course, develop your own voice and maybe your own projects, but also being so, being able to adapt to many different situations. I don't think I can, I cannot compare the workshop here to what we are doing on a daily basis in the school at in Copenhagen. But I have been leading other workshops, but mostly in Scandinavia. And I mean, this time it's of course more exciting for me in some ways because I didn't know any of the students in my workshop. I know some of the students in the whole course, but they were not in my ensemble. So so I tried to bring as much material, as not as much as possible, but a broad range of material. And since I'm working with free improvisation myself as a musician, plus composing, it's a mix of those things. So I both brought some tunes, you could say, some pieces, and also a lot of different exercises and textures for concepts, you could also say, for improvisation. And the ensembles here are quite big. I mean, it's not just a quartet or quintet, there are 9 people in my ensemble. And in that way, I think it benefits a lot the music that you are working with certain structures, but still can balance that with a type of freedom, which is a difficult task also for professional musicians in larger ensembles. I don't have like one advice, but I would say go with yourself, and not in an ego way, but believe in your own ideas and find ways to how and who can help you unfold them. That's one thing. And the other thing is, of course, how will the future be like for freelance jazz, experimental, improv, whatever, musicians. And maybe that's my advice will, of course, be to the, how can I say, the ability to adapt at the same time as you are true to yourself and your own beliefs, of course. To be curious always the rest of your life. not lock too many doors or close too many doors. And don't spend all your time on social media, but spend some time on working with your instrument and your friends and build some groups. And the last thing, which I have, which has helped me a lot and been very good, I think, for my musicianship, is I've been in situations where we built artistic collectives, you could say, like a bunch of musicians make a record label together, or a bunch of musicians do a concert series, or but have that collective way of thinking that can help in a freelance life.